Hello guys, this is Romeo and
welcome to my YouTube channel.
Boom, boom. Well, on today's episode or show or whatever the f*** it is, we'll be building the PC that's behind me, as you can see. Well, yeah, it took me some time to finally complete it, but let me just take you through everything. Well, before we start with the actual building, I'll just show you how the PC looks like, and this is basically what you'll be getting with the money that you'll be putting in for the components, the parts and everything. So yeah, this is how it looks during the day without any power on. And also with my previous laptop, getting 4K was a hassle. I couldn't even play any 4K video. But with this setup, I've eventually managed to get 8K of uninterrupted video play with no scratches or pauses in between, besides the network. So I couldn't play 4K, but on this beast I am able to. And this is how the PC looks like at night. So yeah, that's what you'll be getting. And please note that I don't use these colorful, the rainbow setup. I use a green, a simple temperature control. So yeah, but I know most people prefer use this setting. So yeah, this is definitely what you'll be getting for the amount that you'll be putting in. And going into the actual building, I started by getting an Asus X570 Pro Wi-Fi, the second generation motherboard on Takealot. So I got it for like 2.5. I'll list all the prices and of the components in the screen. And this is how it looks. The board is solid. Yeah, I was happy with the build quality and everything. Although this is my first actual proper build, but yeah, I was happy with the quality. And this is how it looks. As you can see, it came with the back IO plate, the manuals and everything. So this is the IO plate. So the IO plate is actually of good quality, and I didn't have any problems with the back button, the reset button, as some people mentioned on the reviews and everything. So yeah, I am happy with the quality of this metal thingy. So that goes into the bag, and it came also with the manual, the user manual, I think, which is an obvious one in this case, plus a certificate of reliability and everything, all the works. And it also came with the stickers. I've already sticked some into the PC, the complete build, and my screen, because I have a Dell and it didn't have any branding. So thought, damn, let me put this small sticker on the front. And well, it also has some cables for SATA, and yeah, a disc for the drivers. But as you know, I think I don't use a DVD. And for the PSU, I went for a Cooler Master 650 watts MWE. I got it on Facebook Market for around 950. I think the new one cost around 2k. But yeah, so my actual build only needed like 500 watts, but when I saw this one, I thought if I do decide to add some things in future, I'll just be in advantage. Yeah, so this is the quality, and I'm really also happy with the whole design, how it fits the cable management. As you can see, it only uses like flat cables instead of the usual single, or you know, the old setup. But really, really, really is tough, and I was happy. So it came with some screws. Moving on to the actual case, I got it on Takealot for around, I think it was 1150, and yeah, it is also a solid 10 out of 10 for the quality, the cable management and everything, how it handles the motherboard, the whole thing. So this is how it looks like. It has three fans RGB on the front and one on the back, as you saw on the previous video that I posted, that I just played. And for the RAMs, I went for the Dominators. I also got them on Facebook Marketplace for around 1.2 for both. So it's 2x8GB, but I found one was faulty, and well, I went back to the guy and he actually gave me my money back. And yeah, so for the GPU, I went for an RX 580 Aorus Gigabyte, and I got it for 2.5 on Facebook Marketplace. And the packaging was still intact, even though it had been used for like 3 to 4 years. And yeah, it came with everything still intact, the papers, the disc and everything, as you can see in the video. And it was working fine. It is working well. Everything has been fine besides one fan that needs some for the process. I initially wanted a AMD Ryzen 5600X, but I couldn't find it as they were out of stock, and I got it at this international for It was around, I think, 3.5. Yeah, 3.5. And yeah, the performance has been well, because the pieces for music production, it handles the software quite well. Although the setup won't be mainly used for gaming, but it does handle some games pretty well. It'll mainly be used for music production and the likes, because you know, demands heavy processor usage and all these other functions that require RAM, the plugins and everything. So yeah.
At least let me help you. Headquarters is filling, but you've got to hurry.
So yeah, I came through, I faced some problems, but I managed to eventually sort them out, like the RAM, as I've already mentioned. But yeah, I'm still planning on upgrading and getting more RAM, as the motherboard can handle up to 128 gigs, I think. Yeah, 128 gigs of RAM, and yeah, I'm planning on maxing it out. So until next time, please don't forget to subscribe, comment, share your thoughts. What do you think I should improve, where I missed, how I can improve my PC, or any comments that you might have. They'll be really appreciated. This is Romeo, and peace.